Saru. So let's start with the salutation to the triple gem. So yeah, just kneel down. Need to kneel. I will chant, then you all kneel together. Arahang samma sambuddho bhagava buddhang bhagavantang abhivademi. Svakato bhagavata dhammo dhammang sammasami. Suppatipanno bhagavato savakka sangho sanghang namami. So I'll be chanting, requesting for the three refuges and the five precepts first, then the monk will lead us for the five precepts. Mayang bhante tisarane na saha panchasilani yachama dutiyampi mayang bhante tisarane na saha panchasilani yachama taptiyampi mayang bhante tisarane na saha panchasilani Yachama.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa.
Buddhang saranang gacchami.
Buddhang saranang gacchami.
Dhammang saranang gacchami.
Dhammang saranang gacchami.
Sanghang saranang gacchami.
Sanghang saranang gacchami.
Dutiyampi buddhang saranang gacchami.
Dutiyampi buddhang saranang gacchami.
Dutiyampi dhammang saranang gacchami.
Dutiyampi dhammang saranang gacchami.
Dutiyampi sanghang saranang gacchami.
Dutiyampi sanghang saranang gacchami.
Tatiyampi buddhang saranang gacchami.
Tatiyampi buddhang saranang gacchami.
Tatiyampi dhammang saranang gacchami.
Tatiyampi dhammang saranang gacchami.
Tatiyampi sanghang saranang saranang gacchami.
Tatiyampi sanghang saranang gacchami.
Ti sarana kamanang nitidang.
Nati.
Panati pada huwe ramani sikha padhang samadhyami.
Panatipata viramani sikapadang samadhiyami.
Adhinadhana viramani sikapadang samadhiyami.
Adi nadana viramani sika padang samadhiyami
kame tumita jara viramani sika padang samadhiyami
kame shlumita jara viramani Sika padang samadhiyami
Musa vada viramani Sika padang samadhiyami
Suratmada viramani Sika padang samadhiyami
Suramiraya machapamadadhana viramani Sika padang samadhiyami
Suramiraya machapamadadhana viramani Sika padang samadhiyami
Imani panca sika padhani samadhiyami
Imani panca sika padhani samadhiyami Imani panca sika padhani samadhiyami Imani panca sika padani samadhiyami
Sidena sukating yanti sidena bhoga sampadhan Sidena niputing yanti tatama sihrang visotha ye
Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu So, before we start the Sanghika Dana, we'd like to request the monk for a short Dhamma talk, sharing of Dhamma. Brahmacha loka dipati sahang pati katanjali anadi varang acayata sandita satta paraja kata jatika desetu damang anukampiyang pajang
เอาบัดนี้จะได้ปรารภธรรมะให้ฟังก่อนฉันจะที่พวกเราทั้งหลายได้มากล่าววาจาเบื้องแรกที่ว่าถึงพระรัตนตรัยเป็นที่พึ่งคำว่าพระรัตนตรัยก็คือพระพุทธ 1 พระธรรม 1 แล้วก็พระสงฆ์ 1 ด้วยคำสัจจวาจาว่าคำมาถึงพระรัตนตรัยไม่มีอะไรอื่นยิ่งกว่าพระพุทธพระธรรมพระสงฆ์เมื่อเรากล่าวคำสัจจวาจาอย่างนี้ก็ต้องตั้งไว้ในใจของเราทุกคนว่าเราจะเชื่อพระรัตนตรัยไม่เชื่ออะไรอื่นยิ่งกว่าพระรัตนตรัยคือพระพุทธเจ้าพระธรรมเจ้าพระสังฆเจ้า เมื่อเรากล่าววาจาเช่นนี้มีความสัตย์ความจริงใจตัวเราจะไปเชื่ออย่างอื่นเป็นไปไม่ได้เช่นว่าเราจะไปดูว่าดูหมออย่างนี้เป็นต้นด้วยว่าปีนี้ปีเดือนวันเกิดของเรามันเป็นยังไงจะไปเชื่ออย่างนั้นหมอที่ทำนายพูดอย่างนั้นอย่างนี้ก็เชื่อแล้วก็ไปทำตามเขานั่น ใช้ไม่ได้ถ้าพูดถึงพระรัตนตรัยไม่มีอะไรอื่นจากพระพุทธพระธรรมพระสงฆ์แล้วถึงแม้ว่าเราจะเจ็บป่วยเกิดขึ้นในร่างกายเราก็ไม่ได้ไปหาหมอดูไปหาหมอที่เขารักษาโรคทางกายเท่านั้นไม่ใช่ว่าเป็นเพราะอันนั้นเป็นเพราะนี้เป็นเพราะพูดผีปีศาจไม่มี พูดถึงวัฏฏะตายจะเป็นอย่างนั้นถ้ามันเป็นมันเกิดขึ้นแล้วก็ถือว่าเป็นเรื่องกรรมกรรมคือการกระทำของเราเลยกรรมในอดีตกรรมในอนาคตหรือกรรมปัจจุบันเท่านั้นจะไปเชื่ออย่างอื่นนั้นเป็นไปไม่ได้พูดถึงฟารัตนาไตรนี่เป็นอย่างนี้เป็นต้นถ้าไปเชื่ออย่างอื่นยังไม่ถือว่าถึงฟารัตนาไตรแต่ส่วนมากพวกเราทั้งหลายทุกวันนี้ไม่ว่าอยู่ที่ไหนก็เหมือนกันถ้ามีอะไรไม่ค่อยสบายก็คิดไปต่างๆนานาคิดว่ามีสิ่งโน้นสิ่งนี้มากระทำแก่เราหรือกระทั่งว่ามีพูดผีปีศาจอย่างนี้เป็นต้นสิ่งที่มองไม่เห็นก็คิดกันไปอย่างนั้นเมื่อคิดอย่างนั้นก็ไปตามไปหาไปดูไปอะไรสารพัดอย่างแต่จะเปลี่ยนไปบางทีก็เชื่อเขาดีนี่เมื่อเชื่อแล้วก็ทำตามกับเขาก็ทำตามเขาไปดีนี่ก็ได้ทิ้งพระรัตนตรัยไปในตัวโดยไม่รู้สึกตัวจะมีมากๆด้วยมันเป็นอย่างนั้นแทนถ้าเป็นอย่างนั้นไม่ถือว่าผู้นั้นถึงปรัตนตรัยถ้าถึงปรัตนตรัยจริงๆนั้นจะไม่กระทำยอมทำอย่างนั้นโดยเด็ดขาดได้ที่นี่เมื่อเขาถึงปรัตนตรัยโดยแน่นแฟนแล้วที่ก็มาถึงมารักษาศีล5ศีล5ประการที่เรากล่าวตามหลังพระมาเมื่อกี้เนี่ยแต่ข้อที่1ถึงข้อที่5ทุกคนก็คงเข้าใจที่กล่าวเช่นนั้นคือพระนั่นก็บอกข้อห้ามข้อปฏิบัติพูดง่ายข้อห้ามคือไม่กระทำอย่างนั้นเช่นแบบปานาติปาตาเวรมณีสิกขาปัตตังสมาทิยามิเราตั้งใจสมาทานซึ่งสิกขาบทนี้ด้วยการไม่ฆ่าสัตว์คำว่าไม่ฆ่าคือไปตัดรอนชีวิตของเขาแม้แต่สัตว์ตัวเล็กตัวน้อยอะไรก็ตามที่ให้ชีวิตเขาตกล่วงไปนะถือว่าเป็นการฆ่าเราจะทำไม่ได้ทั้งเจตนาและไม่เจตนาด้วยเช่นว่าบางคนพูดอย่างนี้สมาทานอย่างนี้แต่ผลจากนั้นไปก็ไปกระทำเลยยังไม่รู้ว่าตัวเองทำปานาติบาตถือว่าเล็กๆน้อยๆไม่เป็นไรเด็กๆน้อยมันก็ผิดตามเด็กๆน้อยๆนั่นดิยิ่งอะไรหลายอย่างที่มันใหญ่โตขึ้นก็ยิ่งผิดมากขึ้นความเป็นบาปหรือความอันไหนมันก็มากขึ้นตามตัวมาถ้าเราเข้าใจอย่างนี้เราจะไม่ล่วงละเมิดเลยทั้งต่อหน้าได้รับหลังก็ตามไม่มีเจตนาที่จะไปทำให้มันล่วงไปสัตว์ตัวเล็กตัวน้อยสัตว์แม่ของอยู่ในบ้านเราเป็นมดเป็นปวกเป็นอะไรก็ตามทั้งหลายเหล่านั้นเราเมื่อตาไปพบเห็นปุ๊บพอเห็นมองที่ไหนเราจะฆ่าเลยไม่ได้ต้องหยุดซะก่อนมองดูว่าอันนี้เขามีชีวิตไหมถ้ารู้ว่ามันมีชีวิตแล้วก็ไม่ทำเราไม่ทำไม่ทำให้ชีวิตเขาตกล่วงไปแล้วเราจะทำยังไงอย่างอื่นนั้นได้จับตัวเขาไปหรือเขี่ยเขาไปพ้นๆไปไม่มีเจตนาที่จะทำให้เขาชีวิตตกไปทุกครั้งทุกคราวนี่นั่นแหละเธอว่าผู้นั้นมีศีลอยู่ในตัวนี่ข้อที่หนึ่งข้อที่สองอธินาทานอธินาทานแปลว่าความรักรักขโมยนะจะมีอะไรที่มีจิตซุกซุกซ่อนซ่อนอะไรแม้ทุกสิ่งทุกอย่างไม่มีในใจจะทำอะไรก็ทำด้วยความโจ่งแจ้งแล้วก็พูดด้วยโกหกฟกลมไม่มีในตัวนั่นทั้งภายทางความนึกคิดทางวาจาทุกอย่างจะเป็นผู้บริสุทธิ์หมดจดแม้จะคิดจะทำอะไรที่ว่าคนอื่นจะรู้คนจะอื่นจะเห็นอย่างนี้ก็ไม่มีในใจก็ได้พ้นจากการอธินาทานนี่ศีลข้อที่สองกาเมสุมิสาจารธรรมดาวิสัยคนในโลกที่มีครอบมีครัวเราก็รู้อยู่แล้วกามโรกีทางโลกมันก็เป็นอย่างนั้นถ้าหากผู้ใดมีจิตคิดอย่างมีอะไรต่างๆทั้งหลายในเพศตรงกันข้ามบางทีบางครั้งทั้งผู้หญิงผู้ชายถ้ามีความคิดอย่างนั้นมันก็ไม่ถูกข้อไม่ถูกต้องศีลข้อนี้เป็นสิ่งสำคัญมาก ในทางโลกเหล่านั้นถ้าใครทําได้ปฏิบัติได้ศีลเหล่านี้เราก็ไม่ผิดพลาดและก็ไม่มีมูลถิ่นแก่ใจตัวเราเองเรายินดีพอใจเฉพาะในครอบครัวของเรานี่ไม่มีอะไรร่วงเกินเกินกุศลนั้นไปมันก็ไม่ผิดข้อที่ 4 มุสามุสาคือคนพูดมดเท็จอะไรต่างๆพ้นจากความเป็นจริง นี่มุสานี่มุสาวาทบางทีบางครั้งนี่แม้แต่ในสังคมใดสังคมหนึ่งทั้งตัวเองไม่มีเจตนาที่จะทําให้ผิดเพี้ยนไปแต่บางทีบางครั้งในกลุ่มในหมู่ในพวกคือจะพร้อมเพียงกันทําให้มันผิดพูดง่ายเมื่อหัวหน้าพูดอย่างนั้นก็จะให้คําแนะนําแก่หมู่แก่พวกต้องพูดอย่างนี้อย่างนี้อันนั้นก็ถือว่าผิดเหมือนกันมันเพี้ยนจากความเป็นจริงนี่มุสา
มุสาวาทคือพูดเท็จพูดความไม่จริงอันนี้ก็เป็นภัยต่อสังคมมากๆเลยทุกวันนี้จะมีทุกคนทุกแห่งอันมุสานี่มันไม่ดีก็ศีลข้อนี้สําคัญเมื่อศีลข้อนี้ไม่มีอย่างนี้นะทางโลกถึงมันวุ่นวายทุกวันนี้ก็เพราะพ้นจากพูดจากความจริงนั่นที่เด่นเมื่อพูดพ้นจากความไม่จริงความไม่จริงมันก็เกิดขึ้นมาทั่วโลก โลกาโลเลยที่นี่ศีลธรรมมันจะหมดจากโลกเรามันก็เป็นเพราะอย่างนี้นี่สําคัญมากถ้าใครรู้จักอย่างนี้ใครจึงทําได้ตั้งไว้ในตนของเราจะไม่ให้มันผิดเพี้ยนถึงแม้ว่าหมู่เพื่อนจะชักนําน่ะก็จงทําในใจไว้ว่าเราไม่ไปทําเพื่อหมู่เพื่อนทําเพื่อตัวเราเองเราอยู่กับรู้อยู่แก่ใจนะเราอย่าไปให้มันล่วงละเมิดอันนี้สําคัญมาก แล้วข้อที่ 5สุราก็เครื่องมึนเมาแต่ในคำบาลีว่าสุราคือเครื่องมึนเมาแต่เดี๋ยวนี้มันมีทุกสิ่งทุกอย่างที่ทําให้เรามึนเมาไม่ใช่ว่าแต่สุราอย่างเดียวที่ยาเสพติดหรืออะไรได้ๆอย่างที่ทําให้ตัวเราหลงไหลไปเมื่อบริโภคเข้าไปเดียวเช่นยาบ้ายาอียาอะไรได้หลายอย่างทุกวันนี้ มันก็เป็นเครื่องหลงเครื่องมึนเมาเหมือนกันทําให้มันสมองเนี่ยมันเพี้ยนไปจนเต็มบ้านเต็มเมืองซะดะฟัดอย่างกระเพาะสินข้อนี้นะนี่ระวังให้ดีถ้าเราไม่ใส่ใจหรือไม่ฝากใฝ่มันก็ไม่มีอะไรเนี่ยมันเรื่องของนอกกายเราทั้งนั้นเมื่อของนอกกายเมื่อเราไม่นํามาสู่ร่างกายเราแล้วเราไม่บริโภคมันแล้วเราไม่ดื่มมันแล้วอะไรก็ตามเมื่อรู้แล้วก็หยุด อย่าร่วงละเมิดอีกต่อไปมันก็ไม่ผิดถึงมันผิดอยู่เราหยุดได้เราหยุดได้อันนั้นก็ไม่ได้ตามเรามาเนี่ยมันผิดก็ผิดอยู่แต่ว่าเราไม่บริโภคมันมันก็นําโทษมาให้แก่เรานี่จงรักษาให้ถูกต้องทุกขบวนการเนี่ยฉะนั้นถ้าใครทําได้อย่างนี้นั่นพระพุทธเจ้าจะคําตัดคําสุดท้ายไปว่าอานิสงส์ข้อการรักษาในศีล 5 สีเลนะสุกติงยันติผู้ใดมีศีลประจำใจจะมีความสุขสีเลนะโภคสัมปทาผู้ใดมีศีลจะมีโภคสมบัติทั้งหลายตามมาสีเลนิพุติงยันติตัสมาสีรังวิโสทเย ผู้จะเข้าสู่มรรคผลพระนิพพานได้ก็จะต้องมีศีลศีล 5 ประการนี่เป็นสมบัติเป็นมาตรฐานของความเป็นมนุษย์เราฉะนั้นถ้าว่าเราเป็นมนุษย์พบพระพุทธศาสนานี่ที่เรากล่าวกันมาคำว่าพบพระพุทธศาสนาคือได้มาเห็นคําสอนของพระพุทธเจ้าก็ได้ประพฤติปฏิบัติตามคําสอนของพระพุทธเจ้า แล้วก็เป็นมนุษย์โดยสมบูรณ์ถ้าใครยังมีศีล 5ยังไม่ครบขบวนการข้อใดข้อหนึ่งก็ตามนั้นความสมบูรณ์แบบของมนุษย์ก็ยังไม่มีถ้ายังไม่เป็นมนุษย์มันก็เป็นอมนุษย์อมนุษย์คือมนุษย์ยังไม่สมบูรณ์100%นี่มันเป็นอย่างนั้นฉะนั้นเราทั้งหลายจะให้เป็นมนุษย์โดยสมบูรณ์จะต้องนำศีลทั้ง 5 ข้อนี้เข้าไปประพฤติปฏิบัติ แล้วก็ถึงพระรัตนตรัยด้วยคือถึงพระพุทธพระธรรมพระสงฆ์โดยแน่นแฟ้นไม่ค่อนแค่นงอนแงนไม่ไปเชื่ออย่างอื่นให้ถึงพระพุทธพระธรรมพระสงฆ์ถ้ามีอะไรเกิดขึ้นเราจะเจ็บป่วยร่างกายก็ถือว่ามันเป็นเรื่องของร่างกายถือว่าเป็นเรื่องกรรมคือการกระทําของเราที่ผ่านมาก็ดีทั้งอยู่ในปัจจุบันก็ดีถ้าทองลงไปถ้าถึงกรรมเนี่ยกรรมคือการกระทำว่าเราทำดีได้ดีทำชั่วได้ชั่วทำบุญได้บุญทำบาปได้บาปนี่เป็นหลักของพระพุทธศาสนาโดยแท้จริงขอทำความเข้าใจแก่พวกท่านทั้งหลายทุกท่านทุกคนด้วยประการนี้เทอญเอาแปร
Okay, so can you hear me from the back? Hear me? Okay. So today I would like to give some Dhamma reflection before the meal. So first of all, you are all taking the triple gems as your refuge. You take a refuge in the Buddha, Dhamma, and the Sangha. So you utter this truth. You determine to take the refuge on the Buddha, Dhamma, and the Sangha. What you're saying is that there's the highest thing that we uphold, the Buddha, Dhamma, and the Sangha, and we have a faith and confidence in those triple gems. You not believe in anything else. So this is very important that you determine to take the refuge on the triple gems. And if you can keep that, then that's a very powerful and will protect you. But some people, after they take a refuge in the triple gem, they still believe in their horoscope, their star. They go to find their auspicious day, you know, which is a good time to do certain things. So they believe in the horoscopes and believe in all these things that they don't see that have a power over their life. But in the way, this is not correct view. You should believe in your own karma because your karma is the one who determine you are whatever your state of being now is depend on the karma that condition you in the past, either the past life or this life. If you still believe in something else, then you not consider taking the refuge in the Buddha, Dhamma, Sangha in the purest way. So when you take the refuge in the triple gems, and then you keep you also taking the five precepts. This is called the training precept. So all that the monk gives you is a training rules that you have to cultivate the sila by yourself. For example, you also have to understand the meaning of each rule correctly. And the first rule is about not harming, not killing other living beings. Even the small insects, they still love their life, so we should respect. You know, all life is very valuable, so we're not supposed to kill any of those or harm any of these beings. So if it's living beings and we have intention to kill and we act according to that intention and that the beings die from your action, then they consider breaking the precept. It doesn't matter whether the animal is small or big. If it's small, then you may have a little bit of unwholesome. But if it's a lot big animal, then it's very, very unwholesome. So the size of the animal, the quality of the animal may determine what is the degree of your unwholesome, but it's all breaking the precept all the same. So we should have the mindfulness every time we relationship with other living beings, not to harm or not to kill them, both in front of everybody else and behind their backs. You should be able to keep these rules, this precept. I think so it's good to just if there are something that annoy you or irritate you, you just brush it away. Don't try to kill it. The second rule is about not taking what is not given, so not in the theft kind of ways. Try to hide and not to reveal yourself. Try to sneak in and then grasp on something that does not belong to you. Usually, this rule followed by a lie and try to conceal yourself. So try your best not to really be careful about property of others. So we have a respect for the property of all the beings. And the third one is about kame sumichachara, the sexual misconduct. So this is a respect in the family values. So we respect for the people who are not our own spouse. So we, even though we want to seek the sensual pleasure from the opposite sex, but we have to be within the limit of morality, not to do anything that is not rightful. And then the fourth one is not to tell lie. So this is very important that we try our best to stay to the truth. But this day there's a lot of lying going on in the world, especially sometimes the big lie, lie by the leader of the world. So the world is in trouble this day because of that. Some people call it a post-truth society. People not believe in truth anymore because so many lies going on in the news, in the media. So it's very important to stick to the truth and try your best not to propagate and anything that you know that is not true, because this is the first thing that will be gone away. When the truth is gone away, then the sila, the morality, the ethic will gone too. So the world will go into a turmoil and not peaceful. And the last one is about drinking alcohol or any drug that is intoxicate your mind to make the mind dull and not mindful. So not only include alcohol, but any kind of drugs, anything that when you take, it get into your body and it get, basically you lost your mindfulness. So the best thing is not take it at all. But if you have take it before, you just determine not to take it again. So everybody can make a mistake, but the best thing is to not to do the second time. So what we know is wrong, then try to correct yourself. So in the end, the Buddha concludes by saying that sila na sukhating yanti, by keeping this sila, keeping this training rules, then you bring your happiness. Sila na poka sampatha will bring you the wealth, and then sila na niputing yanti, by keeping this sila, will take you to the nibbana, the highest goal for Buddhism. Tasma silang visotaye, therefore we should purify our sila. So the sila is a basic quality of human beings. If you don't have five sila, that means you are subhuman. You are not really at the human level. So we should take the sila and practice it correctly, and then have the Buddha Dhamma Sangha as your refuge, not to check by any other thing that is maybe higher than Buddha Dhamma Sangha. Believe in your own karma. This is very important. It's called worldly samatiti, the right perspective, to know that your life is depend on your karma. If you do the kusala karma, then the result will be happiness. If you do unwholesome karma, the result will be suffering. So this is very important that you have the trust and confidence in your own karma. So this is the foundation for you. If you take a refuge in Triple Gem, practice the precept, the training precept, and believe in the law of karma. This is a very good foundation for you to progress, to do the bhavana, to cultivation, until you can reach the end of suffering, which is the goal of all the Buddhists, that we should strive to follow the teaching of the Lord Buddha. So today, very important day, so Visakha Eve, so I would like to offer this Dhamma reflection to you all.
Mante, we'd like to introduce the monks from the monastery so that devotees have a benefit.
Okay, so for some of you might not know our traditions, we are from the Thai forest traditions. So we introduce Luang Phor Thoon, The first one, he's basically one of the early monks who stayed with Luang Phor Thoon. I don't know, any of you know Luang Phor Thoon or not? Oh, okay, some of you know already. Okay, so Luang Phor Thoon is our spiritual master. He's the one who started this lineage. It's called Thai Forest Tradition. And Luang Phor Thoon is basically his personal attendant of Luang Phor Thoon, taking care of Luang Phor Thoon when he go old and get ill. And he also the first batch of the monks who are very close to Luang Phor Thoon. So he has many personal teaching from Luang Phor Thoon. But because he not want to talk about his own spiritual practice so much, so unless you ask, otherwise he will not tell you what his practice. But Luang Phor Thoon is very close to Luang Phor Thoon. He's very senior now, one of the very most senior of Wat Pah Pong. Any monks who are his age, normally very sick to come, you know, to travel. Maybe they got some diabetes or some problem. So we are so lucky that we have Luang Phor Thoon to come here a few years now, two or three years now. He give up his time to come and teach. You know, it's quite a long work. But now Luang Phor Thoon have some sore throat, so he couldn't talk for so long. So. Okay, so that's the first one. And the second one, Ajahn Ruammit, he also the disciple of Luang Phor Thoon. He's 25 vassa, he also taking care of Luang Phor Thoon, and now he has his own monastery in his hometown. So he's also the Patimokkha chanter. He can chant the Patimokkha, the training rule of the monks. Today is a Patimokkha day. We just finished chanting this early morning. We have to recite all the rules of the monk, training rules, 227 of them. So that is, he is the second one. And me, myself, my name is Ajahn Dton. Ajahn means teacher. So any monk who are more than 10 vassa, you call them Ajahn. Ajahn is mean more than 10 vassa. Dton is just mean the firstborn son. It's called Dton. If you need anybody named Dton, it mean this is the firstborn child. So myself, I was a pediatrician. I studied in the state for a few years, 6 years, and I met Ajahn Chah, one of the disciples of Ajahn Chah. He's an English monk, and I decided to become a monk rather than become a doctor. So I go back home, and then I decided to, we want to follow the teaching of Luang Phor Thoon, and I go to Wat Pah Pong and ordained in Wat Pah Nanachat, International Forest Monastery. I stayed there for 5 years, and now I'm have a monastery called Wat Pah Bunlom, and we have a lot of program with the children, taking the novice summer ordination, things like that. So this is my special interest. And this one is Ajahn Cagino, he Malaysia. He used to be the photographer, worldly famous photographer. He have the photo exhibition. So if you're interested now, it's in Genting. It's the second one now. So Genting Highland. So he captured all those nice pictures of the monk going to Dong, walking in the forest. So only him can capture that. It's one of the very rare moment. So if you want, you can follow his picture there. Okay, next one, Ajahn Yanapalo. He's a Italian and Thai, and ordained in Thammayut. Thammayut is a lineage of Luang Phor Man. So he also joined us for helping with the translation. Okay, he spent the last night not sleeping, practicing all night. So he might be sleepy this morning. So please forgive him. Okay, so next one is Ajahn Lek. He is abbot of Thammakiri now. Ajahn Cagino has become the supervisor now, the senior advisor. Ajahn Lek is taking care of the head of the abbot there. So if you want to go to Mae Hong Son to do some tudong, follow the footstep of the monk, so you can contact him. We have a schedule for Ajahn Cagino taking Malaysia and Singaporean to traveling in the forest, got the first-hand experience of what it's like to live as a forest monk. And then we have the every year in January, Ajahn Chah Memorial Days, very big gathering of thousands of monks, tens of thousands of lay people, doing the practice together for a week, meditation, listen to Dhamma talk, dana, all these things, so you can have your first-hand experience, so you can enjoy. Every 16th of January is Ajahn Chah Memorial Day. It also happened to be the same day as the Teacher Day of Thailand as well. So Ajahn Chah picked the right day of passing away. So when we thinking about our teacher, it's Ajahn Chah. It's the same day, 16th of January, every day. So you can mark your calendar if you want to join the very special time. It's also a very nice time in Isan as well, not too hot, just a nice mystical and very warm and very nice weather. You can practice together and very lot of inspiration to see the Buddhists come together in very peaceful way and try to practice and meditate together. It's very powerful. So when you've been in, and then you can come back and practice on yourself. Oh yeah, and Ajahn Cagino mentioned it's a hundreds of the dana sala. Basically, you can pick and choose whatever food you like. It's like the food festival. So if you just prefer to eat and sleep, okay, you can just go sleep. But if you want to practice further, you go in the monastery. This is like outside the monastery. There's a big dana sala. A lot of people are very generous. They come in and they give out the food. So you can go and have a free meal. But if you're interested, you go in a little bit, you can listen to Dhamma talk, meditate. Sometimes we have a meditate for overnight. And then the last day, 16, we have the circumambulation around the Luang Phor Thoon JD. It's very, very beautiful and very nice thing to, at least once in a lifetime, you have that kind of chance of being part of the Buddhist that is still ongoing in the world. Okay, so the next one is Ajahn. Ajahn Tui. Ajahn Tui, he is ordained in Wat Pah Pong. He also chants Patimokkha. He did it this morning. And he come now, he stay with Ajahn Cagino at Dhammakiri to help with that. And he planning to join the Wat Pananachat to learn more about English and maybe have a chance to maybe speak and maybe take my place, do some translation, hopefully, so I can get my retirement. The last one, Ajahn A. He a personal attendant of Luang Phor Thoon, because Luang Phor Thoon has diabetes, hypertension, you know, like all these OH disease. So Ajahn A will be the one who basically remind Luang Phor about when to take medicine, what is the food that he can have, what the food that he can't have, things like that. So you have to, and he will be keeping the schedules and the thing of Ajahn Luang Phor Thoon. So it's very important for him to take care of the senior monks. So this is how our tradition, we take a good care of the senior monks and try our best to help the monks and also help each other in terms of the practice of the Dhamma. Okay, so just an overview of what we are here. So it's really rare to have the monks coming together. If we come from different monastery, not really the same place, but you know, once a year, we at least we have a travel together and have to know our tradition, and hopefully that you know what is a monk life and you know the forest tradition, how do they practice, and hopefully that you can maybe use that as your, when you think about the Sangha, you have some image of the part of the Sangha that you can recollect and take refuge. Okay, so.
Okay, we will now do a formal offering of food. There is a dedication of dana. Okay, let's follow. Okay, you chant the Namo Tassa together. Okay. Then you down. Ekaditi Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Samma Sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa.
Imani
mayam bante battani Sapparivarani Bhikkhu Sanghasa Ono Jayama Sadhu No Bante Bhikkhu Sangho.
Imani.
Bhatani.
Sapparivarani.
Patigandhatu. Ahamkam. Dikarattam. Hitaya.
Sukaya.
So in English, we present this food of ours together with the accompanying articles.
Together with the accompanying articles.
To the Bhikkhu Sangha.
To the Bhikkhu Sangha.
May our Bhikkhu Sangha.
May our Bhikkhu Sangha.
Accept these foods.
Accept these foods.
Together with their accompanying articles.
Together with their accompanying articles.
For our long-term welfare.
For our long-term welfare.
And happiness. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Offer requisite first.
Okay, so anybody
okay, have if you have any other requisites, you can offer first.
Okay, I forgot to tell you one thing, because I know that Ajahn Brahm come here regularly to give a teaching, right? Ajahn Brahm Wangso. Luang Phor Thoon is a Kamawaja, you know, the one who recite the chanting for Ajahn Brahm to become a monk. So he's a teacher of Ajahn Brahm. So he's a very senior monk. Ajahn Chah is a Upachaya, but he's the one who do the chanting for him to become a monk.
Okay, if you have any requisites, please come forward. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, for those who have any monetary donation like ang pao and so on, yeah, you can place it on the table, right? The monk will not touch, but they'll just place on the table or on the platform that you have.
We are considered very blessed because this morning they did the Patimokkha. Patimokkha, that means they recite the 227 precept. The monks that after recite 227 precept, they come out and then they receive our things, our merits will be very great. Because that time is their most pure already, whatever.
Okay, at the back there, at the food area, can you clear the area? And I need guys, okay, all the guys, can you help to offer the food at the side? Okay, can you move over to the side? Yeah, at the food area, around the food area. The outer ring. All the guys, please stay in the outer ring. There are a lot of seats over here in front. Please come forward. So once the food is offered, so don't offer the second time and don't touch the table anymore. Okay? Try not to touch the table.
So okay, so just a few laymen is enough, then the rest can come back and then have a seat. So not just just few laymen who just offering to the monk, the rest can come back and then have a seat here. Okay, so we just be quiet during the monks, during the dana.
Okay.
And
So just to explain for those who are not observing, did not have a chance to observe there. For the food offering, okay, the monks, you have to lift up one by one the bowl or plates. Okay, then the monks will hold. Okay, you let go your hand. Okay, and then they will put down. So they're very careful, one by one they check so that they don't miss anything. Okay, for the fruits, Okay, for the fruits, basically one of the minor precepts the monk have is they actually don't pluck. They don't pluck from the trees. So for fruits in future, you offer any fruits, especially those with seed, you have to use the fork to poke it or to pinch to punch a hole and chant kapiam bante means that these food are good for offering, good for the monk to eat. So for every of this fruit, you have to punch a hole there, okay, with the fork. Then you chant kapiam bante. Okay,
just the food that has a seed that can grow.
Yeah.
Okay, not right. Every food. Because the monk is, one of the rule of the monk is not even, we have to value the life, even the seed, we're not supposed to break the seed. So how to do it so the lay people can do it? You can basically make it allowable for the monk.
Yeah.
So you just make whatever, maybe the knife or the fork, just poke in, just one is enough. And then just say, kapiang pante, which means it's allowable. So the monk can make use of it without making any offense. So this is a way of helping the monk keeping the Vinaya rules. Okay, so you can do, any one of you can do. Yeah, just say kapiyang pante and then poke it with saying kapiyang means allowable to the monks.
Okay, so yeah, sadhu. Right, so as I say, that forest monk are holding the precepts very tight. So we as a layman, we need to understand who are the monks. And then we try to comply to make their precepts more easy, right? So for the missionary monk, it's okay. They are not so strict, so they can eat from the table. You can offer the whole table. They can eat on plates. And so on. But you will observe that this time they're going to go around and take their own food.
Okay, so you can
the men. Yeah. Oh man, come over here. Don't worry. The monks will help themselves. Yeah. We also have to. Yeah, we need one kapia for each monk, so that in case they want to have extra, the bowl and so on. Yeah, hold the bowl. The bowl and their. Oh, blessing first. Okay, sorry.
Okay, so Luang Phor will give a blessing first.
Yeah, okay.
Iya thawaliwa pura paripurendi sakarang evamevahito dinang betanang upakabati Hittitang madditang dumhang hippamai watamitato sabhe burendo sangkapa Chantho bananaso yadha manito diraso yadha Zamarongo vinadado Mahadeva vandarayo sukhi dikhayu bhava Abhivadana dinesane jangudha bhajayino Chataro dhamma vatante ayu vando sukhang palang Nayudho badadho dhiro
Vannato patipanato Sukham sadhata medhavi Sukham suhati kanchati Ayung tatawa panangwanda Sukham ja patipanato Tikhayu yasava hoti Yathayatu babadati te Pavvatu sabba mangharang Rakhantu sabba devata Sabba buddhanu favena Tathasuti bhavantute Pavvatu sabba mangharang Rakhantu sabba devata Sabba dhammanu favena Tathasuti bhavantute Fawadu sabba mangharang Sāpa-saṅkha-nu-pa-ve-na-dhā-dhā-ro-ti Pa-vāndu-te
Sādhu, sādhu, sādhu. Okay, for those, the rest, please be seated. Give some space for the monks to move over to collect their food. So we have a kapia. Kapia means the assistant to help the monk to carry any food or anything that they want to add. Okay, as I say, this is a Sanghika dana. Okay, it's different from a normal dana. Okay, first of all, we have opportunity to invite more than four monks. So it's a Sanghika dana. It means that this dana is not offered to individual monk. Please remember, it's not offered to individual, but to the whole Sangha community. The whole Sangha community, including the monk here and the Buddhas, and all those Buddhas in the past as well. So it's actually, in the Buddhist context, it's very meritorious. So you are very karma is very good. You have this opportunity to come for today, and especially we are offering to the forest tradition. So while waiting for the monks to come over here, you all may want to calm down yourself, meditate a bit, think of good things, And I always believe part of the dana activities here, make your aspiration by the power of all these meritorious deeds you have actually performed, be it. So it's good making aspiration, especially during Vesa Day, Vesa Eve, right? The Buddha make aspiration to become a Buddha. So let's make an aspiration that by the power of this meritorious deed, may let it be a condition for you to achieve something. Okay?
Brother, sister, in the meantime, I just let you all know the dates. Okay, Mahathera is 1st to 9th of June to visit all the monastery for the abbot. And then Novin's program is in July, 15 July until August 14. Katina is during Deepawali. Mehong Son Katina is during Deepawali, 26th to 31st October this year. 26th to 31st October this year. And then for the Mae Hong Song Monastery visit, is 7th to 12th December, school holidays. Okay, and then we got Tudong program. For those of people who like to climb mountain, who like to go climbing and all this, and who like to try monks living in the forest, you can join the Tudong. November 1st until November 10. Okay, and then we have Satipatthana Meditation Retreat, November 16 until 24th. November 16 until 24th. And then the highlight, okay, every year we will have Ajahn Chah Commemoration Day. Okay, January 8th to January 17. January 8 to 17. You can join half of the program, okay, or the whole trip. You can join half of the trip if you cannot get so many days of holidays, or you can join the whole trip. We will be going to Ubon. And then, because the Ajahn Chah Commemoration Day, we will be going to Ubon. And then we will be going to Luang Phor Thoon Monastery also. Luang Phor Thoon Monastery, Wat Pah Pong, is declared one of the most beautiful monastery in Thailand. Okay, you have been awarded the award before, many years by the previous king. okay, by the previous king of Thailand, because over there they managed to make it very natural. Okay, so you can go to check it out. And then tomorrow we will, the monks will be in, tonight we will have a Dhamma talk in Bubs, okay, 8 o'clock in Bubs. And then if you all want Mandarin Dhamma talk, is in Setia Alam Sambodhi. And then tomorrow Dhamma talk will be in Chittarama. Tomorrow, yes. Tonight is in Bubs, okay. Tomorrow is in Chittarama. Okay, we got the schedule out already. And then on Monday, Ti Ratana will be celebrating Vesak Day. Okay, that means they take one day later to celebrate Vesak Day in Ti Ratana. For all of you that didn't celebrate or want to celebrate, since Monday is a public holiday, you can go there and do Dana again on Monday and bathe the Buddha and bring your children over there, since it's holidays and public holidays. Tomorrow Chittarama also 8 o'clock. Okay, since the monks all take their food already, we end with Arahan Samasam. Okay, we recite together, everyone. Let us bow another 3 times for the triple gem and the sangha. Okay, brother, sister, you all can have your food over there, please.